one of these marbles carved in Parian marble called the head of Selene, which was a horse's head driving a chariot of the moon, supposedly drowning. This particular head I came face to face with on eye level and discovered instantly the wonder and magic and miraculous, extraordinary perfection, I would say. Was it perfection? Was it beauty? Was it harmony? Was it balance? Everything seemed to be wrapped up in one. Somehow my eye rotated across the planes of this fairly shallow piece of carving. Somehow something seemed to balance in a way that I'd never seen balanced in any other object I'd ever seen before. And I suppose it obsessed me initially, and I went back and started work on ideas based around from it and looked at it. I had a plaster cast by chance at school on the desk. And I observed this thing at close hand and researched it, and copied it and drew it and modelled it over and over again. It almost became a three-dimensional object inside my head. And I guess still today, 30 years later, I'm still in wonder and still inspired by some of the great phenomenal Greek principles that have been inlaid into this work, as were exemplified in all of the works of the Parthenon. And it happened to be a horse's head. I suppose that became a vehicle for my expression, my emotion, my way of expressing myself over the last three decades. Encouraged to draw up until about the age of 20. I never picked up a piece of clay until I was about 21. And I look back at that time as always being a constant sort of recording of life around me with a pencil and charcoal, observing landscapes and still lives and life and form and figures and eventually the horse's head, which I've been drawing. And now I'm moving into more architectural work, but it was the inspiration, of course, of the Elgin marbles that were in a sense drawn in marble, carved in marble. But it was the skill and observation of these great masters, who must have had a way of drawing as recording the balance of proportion and the figures that they saw in front of them. Thank you.